With the wave of a wand, Sarah Connor and her UAB doctors know what's going on in her brain. Sarah, 24, has suffered from seizures for 10 years.
I used to have
a long cluster like you did that night.
Two or three a day.
That's the goal.
And they would last between like 10 seconds to a couple minutes. It kind of feels like weird body displacement. Like I'll look down and I'll say, okay, my right hand is literally right here, but it feels like it's somewhere way off there. And then if I try and do something, like I can't even open a door because it just totally messes with motor function.
Then this June, UAB neurosurgeon Kristen Riley implanted a new type of electrical stimulator, the RNS, or Responsive Neurostimulation System, in Sarah's brain. She was the first RNS recipient in the Southeast since the device received FDA approval.
It's designed to record patient-specific brain activity, to recognize patterns in their brain activity, recognize patterns that are associated with seizures, and deliver stimulation in order to help modulate and control their seizures.
The generator, about the size of a flash drive, is implanted in a patient's skull. Electrodes are placed at the location in a patient's brain known to cause seizures. They record brain activity and deliver a burst of electrical stimulation when that activity indicates an impending seizure.
So that's a lot less than it used to be, right?
Yes.
At a follow-up visit with UAB neurologist Neil Bio, the stimulator had been active for just 30 days, and Sarah's seizures had already decreased dramatically, both in frequency and duration.
I have maybe a flash or two every other day, completely forget about it. It lasts for maybe a couple seconds, so now I'm not just sitting there like, really wish I could open this door, but I can't.
And this could be just the beginning. As the system records more information about Sarah's brain activity, Dr. Bio can tweak its parameters to make it even more effective in shutting down seizures. Doctors at UAB's Epilepsy Center say that while it's not for everyone, it's a big step.
This is not a treatment that will cure epilepsy. This is a treatment that will help control seizures in a very specific group of patients who are otherwise not candidates for surgery. I don't expect too many patients to become seizure-free, but if we can decrease their seizures by even half, it can make huge improvements in their lives.
Sarah has certainly seen early improvement with hope for more. The reduction in her seizures will help her finish her degree in elementary education, and she's getting married in the fall. Big changes.
Doing pretty good.